Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Students, today we have a topic from our chapter fractions. We have lesson number 1, fractions and divisions. This is our practice questions taken from the textbook page 67. Question number 1 we have. What is the value of each of the following? Now, have to express your answer as fractions. We have 7 divided by 9. Divide means, in other words, we have to write 7 by 9. This is fraction form, in which first one we have numerator, and after divided sign the number comes, that is the denominator. So 7 by 9 is the answer. Now part B, 5 divided by 7. We have to write 5 by 7. Now students, look at these two values. These two values are proper fractions which are not going to be dissolved. We can't simplify these values. So 7 by 9 and 5 by 7 is the answer. Students, now we have question number 2. What is the value of each of the following? The important is, express your answer as a mixed number. Now we have to get the answer in the mixed number. First of all, we have to rewrite this 12 divided by 5 in the form of fraction. It is 12 by 5. Now we have, this fraction is an improper fraction. So this fraction is going to be more simplified, and we get the answer in a mixed number like this. We have to put 12 numerator inside and 5 outside. 5 2 times 10. 2 we have a remainder. Now the answer is 2 whole 2 by 5. Now we have part B, 8 divided by 6. We have to rewrite this number as a fraction, 8 by 6. We have to express the answer as a mixed number. First of all, we simplify this fraction. We divide both numbers by 2. We get 4 by 3. Now we have an improper fraction again, because in improper fraction, numerator is greater than denominator. Now we divide 4 by 3. 3, 1 times 3, 1. So 1 whole 1 by 3 is the answer. Now we have question number 3. What is the value of each of the following? We have to express the answer as a decimal. There is a rule. When we have to get our answer as a decimal, we must have denominators as 10, 100 or 1000. Now I will show you how we make our denominators 10, 100 or 1000. We have part A, 1 divided by 5. First of all, we have to change this as a fraction. So it becomes 1 by 5. Now we have to convert this fraction as equivalent fraction with the denominator 10, 100 or 1000. We try what it becomes easily. Is it becomes easily 10? So we make it 10. 5 multiplied by 2, we get 10. So the new fraction becomes 2 by 10. So this we have 2/10. So the decimal is 0.2. I repeat, if we want to make any fraction, if we want to convert any fraction as a decimal, we must have at the place of denominators 10, 100 or 1000. So if we don't have any denominator 10, 100 or 1000, first of all we have to make the denominator 10, 100 or 1000, any one from these. So we have in this part, we have denominator 5, we make it 10 easily. We multiply numerator and denominator by 2. We convert this fraction as an equivalent fraction with the denominator 10. Now we get a new fraction, that is 2 by 10. In other words, we say that this we have 2/10. So the decimal number we have 0.2. Now we have part B, 6 divided by 8. First of all, we have to convert this number as a fraction. So we get 6 by 8. First of all, we have to simplify it. 2, 3 times 10, 6 and 2, 4 times 8. Now we get 3 by 4. We have to express the answer as a decimal. What we do? We make the denominator 10, 100 or 1000. 4 can't become 10, so we make it 100. 4 multiplied by 25, we get 100. How we know that 4 multiplied by 25, so we get 100? We divide it. 4 times 8, 4 5 times 20. So we know that 4 multiplied by 25 and we get 100. Now we multiply denominators and the numerators by 25. Now we get an equivalent fraction of, with the denominator 100, 75 by 100. This we have 75 hundredth. So we write it as a decimal 0.75. Now we have part C, 13 divided by 4. First of all, we have to convert this as a fraction. Now express the answer as a decimal. To write the answer as a decimal, we must have at the denominator, we must have 10, 100 or 1000. So we want an equivalent fraction with the denominator 100. So we multiply 4 by 25 to get 100. Now we multiply its numerator also by 25. So when we multiply 13 by 25, we get 325. So 325 by 100. So 325 by 100, its decimal form is 3.25. Now we have part D. In this part, we have 15 divided by 8. First of all, we have to convert this as a fraction. It becomes 15 by 8. Now, students, if we want to convert our fraction as a decimal, we must have at the denominators 10, 100 or 1000. So, it can't become 10, it can't become 100, it easily becomes 1000. How is it possible? So, I show you this. 1000 divided by 8, 20. 8 2 times 16, 4. 8 5 times 40. So 8 multiplied by 125, we get 1000. We must have at the denominator, we must have 10, 100 or 1000 to make the fraction as a decimal. So when we multiply 125 by 15, we get 1875 by, when we multiply 125 by 8, we get 1000. So 1875 divided by 1000, we get 1.875. So this is how we convert a fraction as a decimal. Hope you all understand today's topic. Thank you.